What's up guys, welcome back to another YouTube video. Today's video is basically going to be a disciplined but motivational video. I'm going to give you guys tips on what I do to stay motivated but also disciplined. I'm going to give you guys all the tips I use on my day-to-day routine, so let's get right into the YouTube video. Alright, so tip number one is going to be waking up with a purpose. So the first thing I like to do as soon as I wake up is I like to pray. I ask God to protect me and give me his strength throughout the day. And I like to thank God for letting me wake up another day. And then after that, I like to meditate. I like to meditate for 5 to 10 minutes. And I try to control my breathing because that helps me stay calm. And then after that, I like to make my bed. I make my bed because that's something I don't like to do. But then, number two, I take a cold shower, and that's gonna build momentum to do things you don't wanna do. I don't wanna take a cold shower. I'd rather take a nice warm shower and be all cozy. But me taking that cold shower at start of my day is gonna build up momentum to more and more things that I don't wanna do, but I know that are gonna benefit me. And then that's just gonna build up momentum, and then I'm gonna be able to reach my goals, if that makes sense. But how do you find the motivation to do those things? So one, I like to think about my goals. So my goal is basically, I don't want to put my kids through what I went through. I had to, from a young age, like 7 years old, 5 years old, I had to wake up super early on the weekends to go work with my mom and dad. And I hated it. But now that I look at it at where I'm at now, I am so grateful that my parents put me through that, because I wouldn't be nowhere near the way I am right now if it wasn't for that. I hated waking up early in the morning and just staying at the flea market, because one, I'd rather be with my friends. I'd rather stay home and be able to watch the football games with my dad and all these things. And I never got to do it because I was always stuck at the flea market working with my parents. And basically, me seeing my parents, how stressful they were, how tired, and just they weren't happy. And I saw all that at such a young age, and I told myself, I don't want to live through that. I don't want to put my kids through that. So basically, that's my motivation. That's what motivates me to get through the day. So that is tip number one, wake up with a purpose. So tip number two is basically learn to stop caring about what other people think about you. So what I do is basically, when I get hate comments, or like, let's talk about hate. If I get hate, it one, makes me happy, and two, you have to realize that they're taking time out of their day to text something and to type something. They're wasting time to say something negative about you, and they want a reaction to it, and it's gonna make them even more pissed off when they see that you don't reply or you leave them unopened, because that just makes them feel dumb. So I love seeing hate comments because I just like their comment. So if you guys ever see like hate comments, I'll like it. Because then they're going to be like, what the hell? Why didn't he reply? So, you should be happy if you're getting hate comments, because that means you're doing something well. And there's going to be haters in school. They're going to mock you. If you're trying to make it something outside of a school, college, like, blah, blah, like people say, escaping the matrix. If you're trying to do something like that, and people are going to mock you. Bro, there's people mocking me about taking this big old gallon to the school. Like, they're like, one of my teachers calls me water boy. Like, there's gonna be people mocking you, there's gonna be people selling you stuff, but then you gotta learn to stop caring, because you're, one, you're being different. Two, you're not being like everyone else. You're not being an NPC. Like, I know that I'm gonna come back to, like, let's just say a high school reunion, and I'm not gonna regret a single thing that I'm doing right now because of the life I'm gonna have. And you gotta learn to not care about, one, what people say. Two, they're gonna be like, all he does is go to the gym, blah blah blah. You gotta learn not to care, because one, it makes you happy. Two, what you're doing is for a reason. If they're calling you a pothead, or if they're calling you things like a thought, maybe you are one, and you gotta realize that. So if you're smoking weed every day and you're not doing nothing, you're being lazy all day, then you got, like, that's a good point. And if you're over here having sex with a guy or a girl every single day, or every once in a while you're having hookups, then maybe you are a thought. Maybe you should be getting called that. Actually, never mind. It was a joke. Not really. But basically, you know, that is tip number two. Just, like I said, frick what everyone says. Just focus on you, bro. Tip number three. All right, let's get through it. Okay. This is to build up discipline. It is to put yourself through pain. So you're gonna, one, have to sacrifice the hangouts, the football games, the dances. Two, you're gonna have to sacrifice comfort. And what I mean by that is warm showers. I'm not saying to not take them. What I do is I take a cold shower in the morning and then a warm shower after the gym, because one, it's bad for you to take a cold shower after the gym, because you're just basically not letting your muscle fibers, like, repair themselves. And, like, I don't know the science behind it, but basically, one, how would I say this? You putting yourself through a cold shower in the morning, one, you don't want to do it, and it's taking you out of your comfort zone, but you're basically just putting yourself through pain, because cold showers are painful unless you're a weirdo and you like them. But also, another one is to basically sacrifice things. Like, I like this quote that Alex said, if you don't sacrifice for what you want becomes a sacrifice. Basically, I'm, this is what, for me, I'm sacrificing my high school life, or my high school days, to, one, build my future in a young age, build the things I want to do at, right, like, for the future, and I'm doing it now so I could live out my life, you know, 10 times better when I'm older. So I'm sacrificing my teen years to start off, like, how do you say it? Get a head start in life. So that's what I'm sacrificing. And I know that at the end of the day, it'll be worth it. Another thing is pleasure. You're gonna have to sacrifice that. You're gonna have to stop stroking the chicken, stop fabbing, because one, you know it's not worth it at the end of the day. Once you bust a nut, you're gonna be like, you're gonna feel horrible right after. You're gonna feel regret. You're gonna feel shame, and it's gonna suck. But you have to learn to fail. Like, how do I say this? You're not gonna be perfect. You're not gonna just say, I'm gonna stop fabbing. Like, no, bro, you're gonna fail. But the thing is that you're gonna have to get up, and you're gonna have to restart. And then as long as you restart, then you're good, bro. Alrighty, guys, so basically people were asking me, how do I stay so disciplined? How do I stay so motivated? And I just tell myself that you have goals to reach, and that you know why you're doing it. You know your purpose in this life, and you just gotta do it. There's gonna be days where you feel so tired, you feel like you can't do it, but those days are the days that count the most. Those are the days where God is gonna see if you're really, like, worthy. If you're really you're gonna think about it as a joke, but if you're really him. But basically, there's so many days where I am, like, so tired. I pull up to school and I'm, like, so low energy, but I know what I have to do. I know why I'm doing it. So that's my motivation. my goals. I want to be able to provide and give my future kids the life I wanted, the childhood I wanted, and I'm going to do that. And I know why I'm doing it, because all the little things I'm doing, the videos, the 2 videos a week, the 2 to 3 reels a day, I know that those things are going to get me one step closer to my goal, and they're going to help me provide for my future family and my future life that I want. And I know that I'm going to be able to seek and praise God for everything at the end, and I'm going to be able to help out my fans in the future, all the people I know that I all the things I know that I'm going to be able to do. This is weird to explain, but I know that one day I'm going to be, you know, a big influencer. I already know it. And I can't wait to be able to, like, help out others and help out them with motivation and discipline and getting closer with God and just motivational stuff. And I can't wait to do it. And that's my motivation. But you guys have to find your reason why you're doing it. And yeah, that's basically the end of the video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I'm gonna show you guys a gym session of earlier today, so if you guys want to keep on watching it, just skip. But because the gym clip is, like, you know, right after the outro. So hope you guys enjoyed it. Please leave a like, subscribe, because me and Aiden are putting so much effort to videos. Follow all the socials linked down below. And use my code XAVER10 for 20% off on all bucked up items. I hope you guys enjoy the video. Now enjoy the gym clip. See ya. All I am is a man. I want the world in my hands. I hate the beach, but I stand in California with my toes in the sand. Use the sleeves of my sweater. Let's have an adventure. Sometimes the silence guides the mind to move to a place so far away. The goosebumps start to raise the minute that my left hand meets your waist. And then I watch your face, put my finger on your tongue, cause you love the taste, yeah. And these hearts adore everyone the other beats hard is for. Inside this place is warm, outside it starts to pour. Coming down, one love, two mouths, one love, one house, no shame.